The crowd, the virtual crowd goes wild. Yeah, that was called In a Mellow Tone by Duke Ellington. And that's how we just want to play this whole next hour or so, in a mellow tone for you. We want to just stay mellow. Everybody just stay mellow. We have a variety of stuff here. We have a little Vince Guaraldi, because I love, you know, Vince Guaraldi. He's the guy that wrote all the Peanuts music. And some standards. And we even have a Burt Bacharach mixed in there. And in a couple of songs, you're going to hear our bass player sing one out for you. It's kind of his theme song right now. I'll let him explain that. My name is Jim Ahrend, of course. And this is Milo Jaramillo on bass. My friend John Bartlit over there on drums. So right now we're gonna do a Vince Guaraldi tune called Cast Your Fate to the Wind. Don't we all feel that way sometimes? Dare I make this disclaimer, we're really winging it here. None of us have had any chance to like practice things and work things out, but I've worked with these guys so much, it's really a pleasure to play with them. So we're just gonna wing it for you, like we're sitting in your living room, and here we go. Cast your fate to the wind. Thank you. Yeah. Little Vince Guaraldi for you. Okay, so the title of this song is Alone Together. Need I say more? A perfect quarantine song, you know? And we put a few new changes to it and had some fun with it here. So let's see if we can read this chart down. It's Alone Together by Dietz and Schwartz.
Huh. Hmm. Hello.
Alone together, everybody. Milo on bass, and John Bartlit on drums. And I, right? Yeah. And nice. I say you should sing something. Let's do it.
So leave a ring around, man. I'm gonna call and sing a song to you.
How this feel? You'll understand what Milo's doing in a second as soon as we start the tune.
That's right. Call my little ones. See if they're there. They're jazz lovers too. Hey, put me on speaker. All right, I'm gonna sing a song to you guys. Coming live from the world. All right. Headed home after working another long and hard day, and I see folks sipping coffee in some trendy cafe. I ain't stopping, I just wanna get on home. I've got to get home so I can see my children. From the pub on the corner comes this big loud cheer. They've got that ball game on, they're drinking ice cold beer. Well, I ain't stopping, I just wanna get on home. I've got to get home so I can see my children. Got to get home so I can see my kids. I rise with the sun and I'm out the door. Though you know I never want to leave. I only wish I could be sitting on that playroom floor with my baby tugging on my sleeve. Folks at the office headed out to the game. They had one ticket left and they were calling my name. I said no thanks, I just want to get on home. I've got to get home so I can see my children. Got to get home so I can see my kids. Oh yeah, Mr. Jim Ahrend right here. She's learned a brand new word, and I swear she's grown another inch. The hugs and the laughter, little songs they sing, my kids put joy in my life nobody else could bring. So when I get done working, I just want to get on home. Got to get home so I can see my children. Got to get home so I can see my kids. See you in a while. Thank you.
Right. Yeah, Milo. Yeah. Did they like it?
I love it. Oh. We're going to be here.
That's the best. That's the best. Yeah. We're living with the restrictions here.
That's right.
Distances and restricting numbers. But they enjoyed it.
They know that's their tune.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So the New Mexico Jazz Workshop, I forget when this was. It was last year, I believe, they had Jazz Stories 2.0. And Marcus at the time had asked me if I would consider doing a program of Burt Bacharach tunes because it was Burt Bacharach's 90th birthday. And I said, sure. And then I got home and listened to all the Burt Bacharach tunes that I knew, and I thought, how the heck am I going to make jazz arrangements out of Burt Bacharach? Because it's already so cool just the way it is. But seeing as houses and homes are kind of the theme of what we're doing, this is from that show, and we're going to do it again. It's a Burt Bacharach tune called A House Is Not a Home. It's one of my favorite tunes he ever did. And these guys are seeing it for the first time, so you get to experience it for the first time. Here we go. House is not a home. Here's a corner. One. Thank you. Thank you, guys. House is not a home. Beautiful, beautiful tune by Burt Bacharach. So, how are we doing on time, gentlemen?
33 minutes right now.
Thank you. Okay. Without a watch, I have no, you know, time stands still when you're playing music, right? or listening. Just a reminder that this is sponsored by New Mexico Jazz Workshop, and if you go to nmjazz.org, you can find out more about it, and I hope you consider supporting this organization. It's been around for a long, long time. It does so much for musicians in the area, and we're very grateful to be asked to do this live stream today for you all. So if you're enjoying it, please consider supporting New Mexico Jazz Workshop. What do you say we do that Lullaby Birdland thing? Yeah, we're gonna try something off the cuff. No charts. We don't need no stinking charts. We're just gonna play. This is by is this by George Shearing or who actually did this? I think it's not George Shearing. Oh well, I know he did it, but oh, you I'm thinking of. Oh, you know, two parts fog, one part frog. Mel Torme. He sang that. Yeah, Mel Torme. Okay. Yep, good. Thank you.
see.
You ever been to Birdland?
No. Well, there was that place down here in Naville. Yeah, that one. But no, not the cool one. No offense.
I have been to one of the Birdlands in Manhattan, but they move around. It's not always the original Birdland is not the same Birdland. They close and then they reopen. Because it's hard for jazz clubs to stay in business. So that's what they do. They close and they reopen. So there was a guy named UB Blake. And he wrote a lot of really cool old-time songs. He was an old piano. Well, UB Blake passed, I don't know how many years ago, but my story about UB Blake is that I was going into the city with a friend of mine, and he said, he and his wife said, we have somebody we need to stop in and check in Brooklyn. Would you mind stopping in and checking with us in Brooklyn on the way to Manhattan? And I'm like, sure. And they said, you might know who this is. It's a piano player named UB Blake. And it was, I was so young at the time. I said, oh, I think I've heard of him. Yeah, who UB Blake, let's see. And so I actually, we actually went in UB Blake's home, and he played, you know, some piano, played that real flat finger style, you know. But then come to find out after the fact that this guy's, you know, incredibly famous and wrote all these wonderful tunes. So, you know, it's the dumbness of youth, right? But so UB Blake wrote a song called Memories of You. And I don't know what it is about this song, Memories of You, but it's just the sweetest melody. And I just love it. I've always loved this tune by UB. And we're going to do that for you now. I'm going to noodle a little up front.
Thank you.
Thanks, Yubi. Pretty tune. We're going to swing back to Vince Guaraldi right now. And we're 50. We're going to do one more song for you. We're going to take it out with this. This is a song that describes how I've been feeling for like the past 3.5 months. And it's called Oh Good Grief. It's from the Charlie Brown series. But it's just such a great title. Oh Good Grief by Vince Guaraldi. Thanks again for listening in. And once again, Milo on bass, John on drums, myself, Jim Ahrend on piano, and New Mexico Jazz Workshop. Oh Good Grief. Here we go. One, two, a one, two, three, four. Good grief.